Food and Football series, and basically we have come to the second last episode of Euro 2020's analyzation. I guess everyone must be very excited for tonight's match, as you have watched the match previously, that on Wednesday, England versus Denmark. Denmark scored a very nice goal at 30th minutes, returned so suddenly, really very suddenly I should say, that there was two free kicks, because there was one was when some guy fall down and they just failed. But Scully Christensen fall down in the second time within 3 minutes. There was two free kicks, and the second one they managed to score, and that is thanks to Damsgaard, 30th minute. And also we should say it's really a little bit upset when if you manage to watch the part when England get the goal, because thanks to Denmark's captain KX scored an own goal. If you have watched the one that Kasper Schmeichel missed the goal, I missed the save, as because Kasper has came out and did not expect that to happen. When Raheem Sterling almost scored the goal, and after that KX just kicked his leg and well, he just scored the goal. There was no yellow card and just a goal for a free gift for England. After that, it went on to extra time, as you know, because 1-1 after time, Denmark versus England 1-1. After that, after extra time, there was a penalty kick that Harry Kane scored, but that was not all. It was missed by Kasper Schmeichel, because Kasper Schmeichel managed to save the goal, but there was a rebound and Harry Kane scored in the goal and helped Harry Kane help England to proceed to the finals after 120 minutes. We're seeing our good friend Italy tomorrow tonight at 3 a.m. I mean one morning I should say. Okay, as you can see, the trophy is in their hands now, and you know there's a lot of Italy's last time that they won the Euro, when their Euro trophy was in 1968, which was 53 years ago, and let's get back their Euro trophy at this stage, playing against England, who has no records of getting any Euro trophies before. And it's that we will have a very nice game, as there's Christian Immobile, and also we have Marco Verratti, as he's our savior for Italy. And also we also have a good soccer player called Donnarumma, who is really good for Italy. And we also cannot say miss out our good friend England, who has Harry Kane, the god of England and the Three Lions, and also Raheem Sterling, who has not yet to score a goal for the past matches. Which is of them will get to score a goal, or will they just be goalless? Well, Marco Verratti, just if y'all know that, Marco Verratti just came back from his injury after the last match they played, but the previous match Verratti did not play, I think. The one against Spain he played, and it's good that tonight he will not be injured, because it's a very important role for him as a scorer, Marco Verratti, and 1.65 short guy. He's a very well player, and we will always respect him as a player, I should say. Yep. And Christian Immobile, he's every matches you can see him scoring goals, and we shall see if tonight he will manage to get to score a goal. So my prediction is 1-1 after full time, and also extra time is England winning 2-1 with Raheem Sterling. I mean Harry Kane scoring the goal and letting Gareth Southgate getting back the trophy. Yes, and this is my prediction, and do remember to watch tomorrow's episode, because it's a special edition. No one will have a post-match analysis, but only me, Zhang Yiduan, will help you. We'll give you a post-analysis. And don't forget, tomorrow you have to watch, because we will have two special guests will be on this post-analysis with us, and they'll be they are the experts on SEAL tomorrow. Bye-bye.